What's up, guys? In this video, we will be talking about what smart contract really is, and I'll be giving you some important things that you need to know. That way, you will have a better knowledge on what smart contract is.
Just a quick message, guys. I'm not a professional advisor, so
let's get it on. Okay, so what is a smart contract? I'm sure for those of you that already has experience with crypto or already knows how to trade and all those good stuff, I'm sure that you guys already know what a smart contract is. But for beginners, I would like to let you know what this is, because this is going to be very, very helpful for you in the long run. Okay, so what are smart contracts on the blockchain and how do they work? So a smart contract is a self-executing contract with the terms and agreements between buyer and seller being directly written into lines of code. So basically, it's digital. Okay, so the code and agreements contained therein exist across a distributed, decentralized blockchain network, and the code controls the execution and transactions are trackable and irreversible. So just like, you know, the written contracts that we have in real life, those are irreversible and those are, you know, like written in black and white, right? That's the term that they use. So once it is signed, that's it. Okay, so smart contracts permit trusted transactions and agreements to be carried among disparate anonymous parties without the need for a central authority legal system or external enforcement mechanism. So while the blockchain technology has come to be thought of primarily as the foundation for Bitcoin, it has evolved far beyond underpinning the virtual currency. So these are the things that you need to know. Smart contracts are self-executing lines of codes with the terms of an agreement between the buyer and the seller. Nick Szabo, okay, so we'll be talking more about him later on. Smart contracts deployed to blockchain render transactions traceable, transparent, and irreversible, okay? So let's move on how smart contracts work. You can go ahead and go back to this link if you want to like learn everything about it. But smart contracts were first proposed in 1994. Imagine that, guys. Long before Bitcoin has... Actually, this is like long before Windows XP, right? I think this is like Windows 3.1 back in the day in 1994. If I'm not mistaken, that was like Windows 3.1. If Windows already exists, okay. So in 1994, by Nick Szabo, an American computer scientist who invented a virtual currency called Bitgold. Okay, and in 1998, fully 10 years before the invention of Bitcoin. So Szabo is often rumored to be the real Satoshi Nakamoto, the anonymous inventor of Bitcoin, which he has denied. So Szabo defined smart contracts as computerized transaction protocols that execute terms of contract. So I'm not sure if you're familiar with Kickstarter. It is a large funding platform that's like a middleman between the buyers and the developers of the project. So what it does is, if there's a project, if you are a developer, you can come up with create a project in Kickstarter and then have people fund it. So Kickstarter will be the one to hold the money in behalf of the seller or the buyers, okay? And then once the funding is completed, it will then release the money to the developers for them to be able to utilize that into like creating the project and so. So that was before. I mean, for me, it's trustworthy. Yes, it is a large company and it does that. But I mean, for smart contracts, you know, it eliminates the need for you to have somebody in the middle, like, you know, receiving the money and then funding it. And then once completed, releasing it to the developers and then following like terms and agreements and all those good stuff. Wherein, you know, a smart contract can do that just by you coding it. And then once it's there, right, all of the terms, all of the agreements and all those things that need to be done is already in the smart contract. Therefore, it's going to execute that, right? What's good about that is it's immutable, meaning once you have already programmed that, you are not going to be able to like ad hocly edit the codes to like, you know, be for another terms or something like that, or if you want to withdraw the money or something like that, run with it, right? Just like what rug pullers are doing with like the money of the investors. So with smart contract, once you have programmed that, it's that. Okay, So you can be transparent with your investors. You can be transparent with the community of your project that, okay, so this is our smart contract and all those good stuff. And then it will execute that. So these are like an example. So smart contract audit service for blockchain and cryptocurrency. So this is SciStack. You also have Neven Projects. So trusted crowdfunding platform using a smart contract. So this is actually a good thing. So if like Kickstarter, you know, if they already are implementing smart contract, then that would be great. Because again, it's gonna be, for me, I mean, in my honest opinion, it is safer in terms of your security that, you know, the developers would not be able to ad hocly change the codes when things go south, right? So with smart contracts, guys, just like what I said, what's good about smart contract is that we can build a similar system that doesn't require third party, just like Kickstarter, right? Hopefully that helps in terms of you having knowledge on what a smart contract is. And if you're new to the channel, guys, make sure to click that subscribe button and click that bell. That way you'll always be notified when we upload new videos, educational videos, anything and everything about crypto. So I will see you on the next. I'm out. Peace.